RealAgriculture.com's coverage of Cropweek 2011 is brought to you by the following sponsors: FarmLink Marketing Solutions, BioVision Seed Labs, the Canadian Wheat Board, and High Stick NT.
So, did you see the 8-pass booth?
I did.
What'd you think?
It worked. It got people into the booth. I've never seen plastic used in quite that way before.
In agriculture, at least.
Yeah, and not in Canada.
So, yeah. So the premise was, and we're showing a picture, but the premise was is that there was a doctor taking the pulse of agriculture.
Yes.
But on top of that was this premise of two nurses. Of course, a doctor always needs assistance.
Absolutely.
And he had two nurses, not in knitted nurse outfits, like scrubs, but in plastic-like, what we could say, stripper sort of outfits.
To be polite, yes. Yeah. And it was very successful.
And they had 1,000 people fill the survey.
Yes, and that was the kind of the point, was to get farmers to stop and fill out a survey, and it worked.
Apparently.
So
did you find that this week there was a huge push on crop rotations, but in a bit of a different way? Not all the crop groups saying you can grow more of our crop by shortening the rotation, but it was almost an encouragement. You need to make sure you're following a long-term strategy.
Yes. Certainly the agronomic component of this week, especially in light of disease and all these sorts of things, there was certainly much more kind of cautionary tales as far as tightening up rotations. And when we say tightening up rotations, we kind of mean not rotating at all.
Right.
Canola, lentil snow. Yeah, canola snow. That even canola 1 and 2 is not a rotation.
Yeah.
Certainly at pulse days, the provincial disease specialist I'm actually surprised pulses grow, actually,
right.
In that they do a disease survey every year, and the list of diseases that are out there and the incidence of them was really high in 2010, and going into 2011, as wet as we are, and we'll get to the weather that we're going to talk about, that it's likely to continue, there was certainly a lot more caution out there that you know at some point this is going to catch up with you. So
yeah, well, yeah. It was interesting to hear the special crop people in the canola group talk about how you really need to have cereals in a rotation. That's just different.
You've heard it's in the past.
We're going to get to these estimate of acres of our crop because you're going to be able to grow it every year.
Yeah, exactly. Well, and I think on the outlook side, you know, in past years, it maybe was easier to make the argument for tightening rotations because the amount of money you'd make was a bigger margin, I think, of difference between a lot of crops. This year, what we're hearing, the outlook anyway, and of course it's an outlook, but most crops look very competitive.
Except for mustard. So
mustard.
We need more hot dogs.
Yeah, mustard is just going to kind of do what it does, and regardless.
That was pretty much the only crop. If you look at flax and canola,
everything was either going to stay just as strong, even off the combine, if not stronger, except mustard.
Yeah, okay. So the highlight of the week was probably Drew Lerner, who last year probably picked the weather like almost by the day. He had it so figured out. He has like this religious sort of following among farmers. Mm. Everybody wanted to hear what he had to say. There was like 300 people on Wednesday night here to listen to him speak.
Yeah.
He didn't have a very good story to tell.
No. And in fact, I'm amazed he made it out of there. No, you know what? Farmers really, really like him and respect him in that he has been incredibly accurate. And I think only because of that is he allowed to make it out alive from having such a poor forecast.
Yeah.
It was a really interesting evening. We are in a La Nina right now, which leads to, you know, lots of moisture, unfortunately.
That's
cool
one of the
weather.
Names that were in the
booth. Yes, actually, I believe the one on the left. Anyway, he believes, because La Niñas can, I guess, stop it really kind of abruptly and at any time, and not all forecasters believe that it will stay in effect through the spring and summer. He believes that it will, and that he did say, and maybe this was the saving grace, that 2011 will not be as bad, as wet as 2010, but we're going into the season.
That's setting a pretty low
That really
baseline.
Is. That really is. But we are... I don't know, from my perspective, we're already going in with saturated conditions and overland flooding, all these sorts of things that even if it's not as bad, and it, please don't let it be as bad, we're still going in with so much moisture that even above average precipitation is
well, I said he was mentioning the warmer weather, and I said when I talked to him, I said, so it's gonna be hotter than last year. He said, oh, no. I did not say hot.
No,
I said warmer.
Warmer.
Yeah.
Well, and what he did say, apparently his prediction is that April will be relatively dry. However, he also said that winter is likely, like March and February, March is going to be quite cold. I don't know about you, but there's still usually, on an average year, a lot of snow left in April.
Yeah.
So if we're looking at how much snow we have across much of the prairies, a cold, extended winter, even warm temps in April aren't going to help us all much. Like, or warm and relatively dry. So it wasn't great news. I did have someone ask me about the Peace region. And unfortunately, yes, they are super dry, and unfortunately this La Nina is not likely going to help them all that much.
Which
it's
kind of feast or famine.
Yeah, it's really too bad.
So, lastly, the other issue is we've both been here all week. It's a war of attrition. And, and today's the last day.
We're the only ones left.
The only ones left. Well, and Neil Billinger.
Yes.
So, from Action News. So, the reality is that you see all that happened all week. It's so evident that pulses are a huge part of the province of Saskatchewan. It's like Bon Jovi was in a concert here. There was plasma screens, there were sound checks. 10 years ago. It was nuts.
Yes. Yeah, and I mean, I haven't been here, you know, year over year like everyone else, but that's pretty typical. It's an interesting group because farmers are engaged and interested, and the crowd's always a little younger, which I find kind of interesting. And they've always got top-notch speakers, and the room is packed. And I will say, year over year, it's probably that. And although this year, any presentation, didn't matter which commodity group it was, if you had weather or outlook in the title, you to the rafters. So that's really what's on farmers' minds.
But to the point where they have plasma screens in the hallway.
Oh, yes.
The room gets so full, and people want to talk.
And people
you
go on
you can watch
out.
The presentations in the hallway.
Yes, absolutely. And and people do. And it does. It fills right to the back of the room. And every table is full. And good questions, too, which is really nice, is that although it's packed, and they've got music intros, and they got the whole bit, it is a bit of a staged production. It's also... you know, people are really interested, not afraid to stand up and start some dialogue and conversations, and I find that it's a really great learning experience, and there's some neat things that happen.
Okay, Lyndsey, that's the update for Cropweek 2011 in Saskatoon, so we'll see you again soon.
Yes, thanks.